Hey, how you doing, Justin? Back with you for a look at a really, really nice 6/8 strumming pattern. It's definitely one that you should be working on if you're going to learn any songs in 6/8. So let's start by going through basic 6/8 time, where we're going to be strumming a down strum on every beat. So we'd have this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Accenting the 1 and the 4 if you can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Big, small, small, big, small, small, big, small, small, big, small, small. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the pattern that we're going to check out is missing beat 2 and beat 5. You end up with this. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. You can see that my hand is moving continuously still. So the actual movement between just doing all down strums, doing this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hasn't changed. I'm just missing beat 2 and putting an and after it. 2 and 3, 4, 5, and 6. 2 and 3, 4, 5, and 6. Down, up, down, down, up, down. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, this is likely to take you a little bit of practice. It's going to feel a little bit awkward the first couple of times that you try it. So you really want to be thinking 1, 2, and 3. That's the key thing here, is the missing the down strum on beat 2 and on beat 5. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. 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 If you've done your training properly and up until this point you've concentrated on keeping your hand moving continuously all the time, you probably won't find this strumming pattern too much of a struggle. It'll just feel a little bit weird because it's different. It's not harder. Again, practicing it really slowly is important, but you will find there'll be a point where, almost like riding a bike, we're going that little bit faster, like 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. That kind of feels easier because it's that little bit faster. Again, if you add in some extra strums, if your hand keeps moving, it's okay. Particularly with this one, adding an up after beat 6 can sound real nice to have. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 1. So you really can get a bit experimental here if you want. The key thing is to learn this one basic strumming pattern, get used to playing in 6/8, maybe learn a tune or two that is in 6/8 as well, so you've got it put into practice. But remember that you're kind of free to experiment with the pattern, the same as we did with the 4/4 time. You can more or less put the strumming where you like, so long as you keep your hand moving, and it's a whole heap of fun.